time of his death, Lucky Dube was South Africa's biggest selling reggae musician. He was aged 43. Dube had recorded 22 albums in isiZulu, English and Afrikaans in a 25-year period. His recording company is commemorating him in a special way.
We wanted to commemorate his life and his music. So we decided that, you know, when you look at all the songs that he's created, right from the beginning, I mean, he's been making songs for so many years and he's changed so many people's lives in different generations. What type of a rich man are you? Who doesn't care
about helpless people? Lucky Dube is also credited for bringing African reggae to the mainstream with numerous successful and critically acclaimed albums. He was also known for his electrifying stage presence and as an outspoken commentator on political and cultural issues. A decade after his death, Dube still commands a legion of fans.
She took me outside. Church, yeah, showed me grace on the ground.
For us, the evidence is in the sales of the music. You know, you go to a reggae party, it's that's what everybody is playing. I think he still stands very much as one of the top reggae artists in Africa. He's still much celebrated. It's very exciting for us to see that. And I think based on that, we knew that something had to happen. You know, we had to do something this month just to kind of, you know, give thanks to somebody who kind of changed what reggae would have been.
If you look at Lucky Dube as a musician and the type of music that he did at the time, he was popular in the country. We were in a transition from the early 80s up to the mid 90s. This is transition from apartheid to a very like democratic, non-racial, non-sexist South Africa, and Lucky Dube's music facilitates this, because if you look at his music, you can see that it is a project of social cohesion. You know, some of his tracks, "We Are One People."
I think it's the message of like on his music, you know, because he take a lot of social occasion, you know, cultural exchange, love and unity, you know, to all Africans, to everyone in the world, you know. That's what he was preaching, peace, love. I think he put a lot of African element on his music. That's why he was outstanding to all of other artists, you know, that were doing reggae in South Africa at that time, you know. And even this time, his music is still relevant, even his time.
The limited edition commemorative album includes well-known hits such as "I Want to Know What Love Is," "Prisoner," and "Remember Me." The album also includes three previously unreleased songs for fans to enjoy. You listen to Jamela CGTN, Johannesburg, South Africa.